Hey everybody, welcome back to Ragtag Stacking. In today's video, I'm going to be going over some tips on some ways to hide your gold and silver stack throughout your house. Hey everyone, welcome back. Like I said, this video is going to be talking about different ways to hide your stack around your house, your silver and gold stack. I know a lot of you, they do have you have a big safe that's bolted down to your, bolted down to the ground. It's heavy. It's, that's where you store your precious metals and everything like that. But I don't think that is the best thing to do with all of your precious metals, having it all in one spot like that. Because if someone happens to rob you while you're home, maybe one or two people break into your house and they manage to, persuade you to open your safe, or they grab a loved one and persuade them, or persuade you with them to open your safe, and then boom, you have all of your silver and gold there. So I don't think it's the best idea to have your entire stack in one spot, just because of that chance of, being compromised, or the burglars compromising the safety of your family, and you have no choice but to crack open that safe. You know what I mean? So what I'm going to be focusing on is burglaries that happen when you're not home. So it's there's not going to be that chance of cracking the safe for them there. So obviously this safe is a good thing to have a big chunk of your stack in. I'd say all of your silver, just because it takes up a lot of space and it's different sizes. You know what I mean? You could have tubes, you could have all your coins and flips, you could have your coins and capsules, 1 ounce bars, 5 ounce bars, 10 ounce bars. There's more of a variety than you would, well, than most people would have with their, than what they would have with their gold stack. So as far as the big safe bolted down to the ground, that's the number one thing that you should have to store your precious metals in. And as I said, I would put all of the silver in there just because of the weight and all that stuff. And some people have 1,000, 2,000 ounces of silver, Put it in there. As I said, if the situation happens where you're persuaded to open the safe for intruders, then you're going to be, you will be losing the silver, but it's not your entire stack. And as I said, gold, it's a lot smaller, more dense, and it is obviously more expensive stuff, and it's easier to hide around the house. So I wouldn't have, you may put some gold in there, but I would not put any of the gold in that safe. What I would do is, I started thinking about what burglars do. I started trying to think about how a robber would think. And then you also have to think about the layout of your house. And the way most of the things happen is they get in, or they break in through ground floor windows, the front door, the back door. It's mainly accessed through the ground floor. So I wouldn't have any of my hiding spots on the ground floor. I want to maximize the time of them having to search the house to, even be in the area of where I've hidden the stuff. So I would have it on the top floor or the basement. And the one place that I think isn't a high priority place for them to search is the laundry room. You're not going to be getting people breaking in for that 8 to 10 minute spot. As I said, the FBI said that it's a home invasion lasts anywhere between, the average is 8 to 10 minutes there. So they're not going to be wasting time hauling up a washer and dryer to steal in that 8 to 10 minutes average that they have. There's not much valuables that's going to be in a laundry room. There might be a jar of change. You check your pockets for any loose change before you throw it in the washer and dryer, and you throw it into the jar. You could have 20, 30 bucks saved up there. They might see some expensive clothes on the ground. They can steal a couple $100 pair of jeans, or, a nice shirt or something. But it's not really high on their priority list. So if you picked up diversion safe of like a Clorox bleach bottle. And it's got a very, very big opening. I think that you would run into, you would be able to put as much gold as you're comfortable putting in there in one spot. I think you would reach that point quicker than you would actually filling the bottle up. You know what I mean? You could fit a, you know, 5-6 ounces of gold in there with that opening. So it's a lot of money that you can fit in there. And I'm saying that you'll probably reach that point of, I don't want to put any more in here. There's already enough money in here. So you close up that Clorox diversion safe, just throw it in a cupboard down in the laundry room. You put other Clorox bottles around it. And I mean, they're not going to be wasting their time going through laundry room cupboards. Another house, another area in the house that's not really a top priority, I would think, for the burglars would be the kitchen. Sure, there are some expensive stuff. There is some expensive stuff that they could take in the kitchen. You know, let's just say they eyed, you know, a couple thousand dollar espresso machine. You know, that's on the countertop. That's just a cursory look throughout the room. They spot it, they get it. They didn't have to go opening through drawers and this and that to find it. They just did a, you know, a search of the room, see if anything caught their eye. So one thing that you could do with that is you could have this. It's actually like a Pringles can, it's a diversion safe. It's got a big opening so you can fit like 1 ounce gold coins in there. And you know what I mean? You can go ahead and put that in your pantry, put other Pringle cans and other cans. There's the bean cans as well. You can get a diversion safe that's green beans. You just put your stuff in there, put it with your other green beans. No burglar's going through the pantry. You know, there's no insurance adjuster that's going through their claim saying they stole my TV, they stole my iPad, they stole my green beans. You know what I mean? I actually got this Coke can that's a diversion safe. Now this one is actually perfect for cash, as you can see there. If you roll up the cash, this is only $80, but you can see it's very thin. If these were all hundreds, that would be $400. And as far as the diameter of it, if you had all hundreds in there, you could get a couple thousand dollars rolled up in there. You can roll this tighter. I bought it. The dimensions, they'd said the dimensions when I bought it, but it's obviously you try to put like a coin in there, a 1 ounce coin. I think like even a 1 ounce gold coin probably wouldn't fit in there in a capsule. You might get a 10th ounce coin in there, maybe a half ounce coin. But these Coke cans, if you have cash on hand in your house, you know, buy 2 or 3 of those cans, get about, you know, $5,000-$6,000. You just put it in with the rest of your cans of pop. You know what I mean? You pick one Coca-Cola box, a 12-pack, you throw 2 of these in the pack, you throw it in the bottom of the pantry, you put other Coke cans on top of it, other 12-packs on top of it. They're not going to be going for pop. You know what I mean? And another spot that it is targeted a little bit on home invasions is the bathroom, but it's targeted for one specific reason, and that's the medicine cabinet is to get prescription drugs. So if they do go into the washroom, they're going to be going there for one particular reason. You know what I mean? They're not going to be going through the toilet paper rolls to see if you have cash stuck through there or anything like that. I'm not saying to do that, but I'm just saying as far as being in the washroom, their main focus is that medicine cabinet. So if you were to have like a bunch of the, you know, Comet drain cleaner and stuff like that, that's a, you know, very common thing that you have in the washroom under the sink and everything like that, get the diversion safe one of it. You can fit some coins in there. You can fit some, you know, you can put some cash in there and stuff like that. You can even put some, in some of these bigger diversion safes, you can put some silver in there too if you want, just to have your stack dispersed around your house. These are just some areas and some thoughts that you could use. So yeah, you might be uncomfortable not having the gold in the big safe, but as I said, there is a chance or a risk of you know, someone persuading you, like I said, into opening that safe if you happen to be home at the time that they're, you know, burglarizing your house. So there is that fear. So if you're not home and some people break in and they see that big safe bolted to the ground, it's really not going anywhere. They're going to look at it. They might try, you know, 2 or 3 minutes to break in with a crowbar or something like that, but they don't want to waste their time on something they know is going to take up a lot of time. So they're going to be going throughout the house looking for other things they can take. But as far as these spots, I think they're very low trafficked areas for robbers. I don't think a lot of people that are breaking into a house are running down to the laundry room thinking this is the jackpot. I got to spend my 8 to 10 minutes combing through this room to find something. So if you just get a diversion safe and you kind of hide it behind things like the three layers, don't have it right out in the open. Like I said, with the espresso maker, you're not going to be taking that. It makes sense. It takes up a lot of space. You're not going to be putting it away after every use. So it's going to be on the countertop. So if somebody walks into the kitchen, boom, espresso, $5,000, $4,000 machine, they're taking it. They're not going to be combing through your pantry on the offside. They might, you know, put, they're not going to be doing that. There's not going to be any incentive for them. They're going to be, a lot of the times they're going to be going in here looking for electronics and jewelry and stuff like that. They're not even going to think that this person might have like a Fort Knox style bullion, gold coins and silver bars. You know what I mean? They're going to be looking for the iPad and the phone. So if you can find little strategic ways to hide away the cash like that and hide away your gold, and not have them all in the same spot. That's the big thing. All having it all in one big safe. That's just, you know, like a Zoom radar for people to go in, and that's where everything is. So don't have everything be in there. You know what I mean? Just gonna, you know, just diversify it a bit. So thank you for listening to that. Hopefully it made sense. Hopefully some of you guys are seeing where I'm coming from. Let me know how you store your silver and gold, whether you have it like in the all eggs in one basket type thing. Let me know what some of your security is, whether you have a persuader as well to defend yourself. So yeah, let me know what your strategy is. And I mean, don't, everyone is not going to be giving away their exact hiding spot, but just, you know, whether it's, you know, in your room or if you have it in several different rooms, and if you happen to take advantage of some diversion safe stuff like that, I just like to know how some of you store and hide your stack, because I know a lot of you have, you know, a lot more than I do. And if security is, I know how much security is on my mind for the little stack that I have. So I can't imagine how people with, you know, tens of thousands of dollars worth of silver and gold in their house, how they're trying to secure it. So anyways, that's it for the video. Thank you for watching. I do have a, I'm going to be doing a channel giveaway when I get to 250 subscribers. So if you're not already subscribed, make sure you, you hit that button and the bell beside it, the notification bell for whenever I release a new video. And yeah, thanks again for watching. If you enjoyed the content, make sure you hit the like button. And yeah, I hope to hear from you in the comments about that. And I will see you on the next video. Thank you.